In Geneva, the 64th World Health Assembly got underway with representatives from the 193 member countries, including the UK's Health Secretary Andrew Lansley, in attendance. A rallying call for change came from the WHO's Director General.
When WHO was dealing mainly with germs, hygiene, medicines, vaccines and sister sectors like waters and sanitation, our job was much more straightforward. But that job has changed. It has changed gradually over time and then dramatically within the last decade. Reform is essential. And WHO is now embarking on the most extensive administrative, managerial and financial reforms.
One issue is the increasing complexity of getting agreement on public health, such as vaccination programs or controlling tobacco.
We have to learn to work together with diplomats, because and not only diplomats. The question is intersectoral, because you have the Minister of Foreign Affairs, but also the Minister of Economy, very important in influencing health and the organization of the health work in these countries. So the health diplomacy is a field that has much more than doctors and diplomats.
It can mean something else for every country. It can then mean negotiating the access to the medicines. It can mean negotiating the responsibilities of the respective countries, the responsibilities of their ministries of health. It can mean negotiating who pays for this. It can mean negotiating who controls it. So while the public health issue might seem very clear, we have the evidence this is what needs to be done. Getting agreement on who should do it, who should pay for it, and how it should be implemented is yet another part of the story.
The Swiss Interior Minister acknowledged health diplomacy now entering a new phase.
The World Health Organization has to play its role fully as the foremost authority of public health throughout the world. The WHO has to clarify its place and its cooperation with all its partners and to define new mechanisms for consultation and cooperation.
The World Health Assembly, the governing body of the WHO, is setting policy priorities for the next year.